HomeKit is Apple's smart home platform with deep Apple Watch, Mac, iOS integration. It just works. It's in Control Center. It's one of the best home apps if you use Apple. But not everything is super easy. In fact, Apple Home is probably not the only app you'll have. Here's my whole room setup. The automations I have, the devices I have, and why. These are Govee light bars, and a lot of the products in this video are from Govee, but Govee doesn't support Apple Home, which is why we need a software called HomeBridge to get them on it. I'll explain more later. Directly under these, I have this desk light strip from Govee. Also, the lights behind my bed are from Govee, along with this lamp and these hexagons and the shelf lights. So I'm editing this video, and I'd just like to clarify that Govee did not sponsor any part of this video. Yes, they gave me a couple products for free, but that was unrelated. I won those in a contest on their app. Govee, if you would like to sponsor me, that would be incredible, but I just genuinely love their products, and that's why I have so many. Also, the Govee M1 strip that I use behind my bed, it has Matter support, so technically, yes, it would work natively with HomeKit, but I didn't do that. I just use HomeBridge. So if that's a deal breaker for you, please be aware of that. And yeah, that's about it.
This is my Raspberry Pi running HomeBridge.
For those of you who don't know, a Raspberry Pi is a mini computer that can be used as a server. And HomeBridge is a software that integrates non-HomeKit supported devices into HomeKit. This is my Blink camera that I basically use as a motion sensor. Please note that this is not HomeKit supported, but it does have a HomeBridge plugin, but you can get banned for using it, so I don't even have it in HomeKit, I just use Alexa routines. I use Alexa routines even though you could do everything in HomeKit automations, I just prefer it. A lot of these you'll see have theme names, so when a lock corresponding to that theme is unlocked, it'll enable those scenes. You'll see how that works later. I also have this simple one that at 10:15, the lamp goes dim and everything else turns off. At 11, my charger for my watch turns on, and at 12, it turns back off. At 5, it turns back on, and at 6, it turns back off. This is pretty much just to prevent overcharging. I don't need it at 100%, so why let it charge to 100%? This one just turns on the lights 60 minutes before sunset. These are the motion and weekday motion ones, so when I'm not home on a weekday, I don't want them to turn on with motion. Of course, I still have notifications from motion. And then this just sets the Alexa volume to something for the day. And this one is for the night. This one just sets all the lights to warm white when it's nighttime. And these are not.
Sorry, I didn't get that. Please try again.
Huh. So for those locks, I created SmartThings virtual switches. So basically, this is not a real switch, and I can lock or unlock it. When I unlock it, you'll see that it relocks itself in a second, and it is changing the theme of my room. And then the last piece of this virtual switch theme changer is the SmartThings plugin in HomeBridge. Here are the other plugins I also have. I don't have that many. I like to stick to just a couple brands. You can see that under security, these locks are here. And so if I pick, say, blue and white, it says unlocking. And then the Alexa routine runs, my theme changes to blue and white, and then it relocks it. If you like this video, hit the like button and comment down below. If you did not like it, comment and tell me why. YouTube thinks you'll like this video, so click it.